Hey there, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily and I do mostly Salesforce tutorials, but I do sprinkle in some related software tutorials here or there. Today, we're going to be going over how to subscribe to a report within Salesforce. So first things first, I'm on the homepage of Salesforce. From here, you can either go to reports or underneath the blue cloud, go to the 3x3 and you can search for reports. I'm going to click on it. It'll take you to the exact same place regardless of which one you clicked on. From here, you're going to want to choose the report that you want to subscribe to. So you can search for different reports in the different folders. You could even go to all folders and just search for the report. Going back to recent, I want to subscribe to my contact report. And there's a variety of different reasons why you'd want to subscribe to a certain report. You possibly want to see it every week to understand how you want to allocate your time during the week, or possibly at the end of the month to understand how well the company did or your employees did at the end of the month. So over here, I'm going to go to the caret in the top right and go down to subscribe. From here, we can change the frequency. We could get it daily, choose a time, attach a file, weekly, choose which days. You could even choose multiple days and the time that you want it and attach a file. And then you can choose monthly relative to the first Monday of the month or whatnot. So like if you wanted to go to the last or the fourth something of the month, possibly if there's a fifth option, it would make it a little weird. You could also have this be specific, so you want this on the very specific day that you want. And you can choose the time that you want it to arrive in your email inbox. Usually I think 7 a.m. is a great time because then it hits your inbox before you are at work and it's the first thing that you're going to see in the morning. You could choose the recipient to be yourself or run it as yourself or as another person. And you can also set up conditions for the report, but I'm not going to do that now. Hit save and you are now subscribed. Congratulations. Thank you so much for joining me for this tutorial. This is a part of a bigger series I'm doing on my channel on reporting and dashboards that'll probably have about 50 videos on that subject. So if you're interested in learning more about that, that'll be the first link in the description box. Like if you found this helpful, subscribe if you're feeling generous, and I will catch you guys in the next one.